we'll be there.
You want to see me, J.B.?
Yes, I want to see you, Bert Brent. You've been opening that fat yap of yours about opportunity. Well, here it is.
Yeah? Opportunity? Thanks, boss.
I'm having a lot of trouble with that picture down in Nashville. Now, can I trust you to go down there, put the show on the road, and sign up the talent?
Certainly, boss. Trust me.
Now, here's the kind of names we have to have. We have to have guys like Marty Robbins, Johnny Cash, Hank Snow, Kitty Wells, and don't forget, Farron Young.
Oh,
I've already got Connie Smith signed. Now, I'll make arrangements for her to meet you at the airport. She'll put you in touch with all the biggest names in country music. You understand that? Now, get on the right airplane, get off at Nashville, and remember, Connie is a girl, not a boy. Never mind about the whistles. Now, look here, flea brain. This is the last chance you're going to get around here. Don't muff it.
Muff it? Who, me?
Oh. And when you get down there, call yourself Colonel. That'll impress him.
Colonel? Gee, I never even made private.
I can understand why. Now get the show on the road.
Are you Colonel Beedlebaum?
Oh, yeah, I'm Colonel Beedlebaum.
Well, I'm Connie Smith.
Connie Smith?
Mr. Grover asked me to meet you. Could I give you a ride downtown?
Yeah, well, that would be nice.
Marty Robbins is recording now.
Gee, that's great.
Maybe we can talk to him in a minute.
Hey, Johnson, we've already got this one down pretty well. Let's take one and put it down on a tape this time.
To my injury, you please. Count me out of future plans you might be making. No more foolish chances am I taking. You played love's game too rough. As for me, I've had enough. Cause the going's got too rough, so count me out. Kept on till you killed all my love for you. Doing as you please became a part of you. You can't blame me now for walking out on you. Count me out of future plans you might be making. No more taken. You played love's game too rough. As for me, I've had enough. Cause the going's got too rough, so count me out.
Hey, Bill, instead of listening to it back, why don't we go ahead and cut Devil Woman since we're pretty well balanced out here, okay?
Okay, Marty, tape's rolling. Stand by.
I told Mary about her, told her about her great sin. Mary cried and forgave me. Mary took me back again. Said if I wanted the freedom, I could be free evermore. But I don't want to be, and I don't want to see Mary cry anymore. Oh, devil woman, devil woman, let me. Devil woman, let me be. Leave me alone, I want to go home. Mary's waiting and weeping down in our shack by the sea. Even after I've hurt her, Mary's still in love with me. Devil woman, it's over. Trapped no more by your charms. Cause I don't wanna stay, I wanna get away. Woman, let go of my arm. Oh, devil woman, let go of me. Devil woman, let me be. And leave me alone, I wanna go home. Running along by the seashore, running as fast as I can. Even the seagulls are happy, glad I'm coming home again. Never again will I ever cause another tear to fall. Down the beach I see what belongs to me, the one I want most of all. Oh, devil woman, don't me. Devil woman, let me be, and leave me alone, I'm going back home.
Hey, Connie, you cute little hun. What are you doing out here?
Hi, Marty. I just brought someone over to meet you. This is Colonel Beedlebaum, and he's a big movie producer from Hollywood.
Oh.
I am?
Oh, yes, I am. Mr. Robbins?
Yes, sir.
I'm with Mishmash Productions. We're doing a country music show, and I'd like to discuss a part in it for you.
Oh, goodness, a part in a movie. Well, that's real interesting, I'll tell you that. But, well, some of the boys and I have got a little race scheduled out at the track this afternoon. Maybe some other time. I'll see you later. Connie, I've got to run.
But it's a movie. The races, eh? Horses?
Now, let me see. Was I supposed to pick up Connie in 20 minutes, or was she supposed to pick up me in 40 minutes? 40 and 20 is 60. That's an hour. An hour. Man, 40 and 60, 120. Across a B with a doorbell, you got a humdinger. Oh, no, no. No, it's an abalone and a crocodile. You cross an abalone and a crocodile, you get an abigadile and a crocabalone.
I'll tell you, that's good. And if we one more rehearsal, I think it'll be fine.
Oh.
Who are they?
That's the Stoneman family.
Oh, sure. I'm Colonel Beedlebaum. I'm doing a movie about country music, and I'm looking for some talent.
Talent, huh? Studio's loaded with it.
Like who?
Well, let's see. We've got Webb Pierce over in Studio B rehearsing a new show.
Ah, could I see him?
Well, see, why not? Come on.
Great.
What makes you strut around town just putting me down when you ain't no better than me? You stay on the run just a wagging your tongue, but you ain't no better than me. You ought to be ashamed the way you slander my name when you ain't no better than me. Because you haven't been seen, don't make your hands so clean. You ain't no better than me. There's a little something that you should know, and I'm just the one to tell you so. You put your breeches on one leg at a time, and that's the very same way that I do mine. You pass me by with your head up high. You ain't no better than me. Back on, you're just a flesh and bones. You ain't no better than me. There's a little something that you should know, and I'm just the one to tell you so. You put your breeches on one leg at a time, and that's the very same way that I do mine. You pass me by with your head up high. You ain't no better than me. Burn on, you're just a flesh and bone. You ain't no better than me.
My closing song is a song that I want you to take a listen to. It goes kind of like this.
Life was so sweet when I first met you. It seemed I had the world at my command. But now I have vision of a future so blue. Love's something
I can't understand. We had this quarrel, then we parted. Well, I just let things get out of hand. So now look at me, a boy broken hearted. Love's something I can't understand. In a state of anger, I said things I didn't mean. Now my world has ended. I've lost everything. So now look at me, a boy brokenhearted. Lost something I can't understand. Lost something I can't understand.
Hiya, Connie. How are you all doing?
Fine, Marty. I see you're all set to go.
Mr. Robbins, I want to talk to you about that movie I'm making.
Well, I'm awful sorry, Colonel, but some of the boys are waiting for me now. Binkley and Cuckoo and Welder and Hamilton, maybe some other time, okay?
Mr. Robbins, you've got a chance to be a star.
Robbins Racing? Beedlebaum, you know the studio policy about our stars engaging in hazardous sports. Get out there and stop him. What about our investment? Hurry up, stop him.
All right. I will, but I can't. I haven't even got him signed up yet.
You haven't signed him? Well, get out there and sign him. Beedlebaum,
All right, I'll try again. I'll see him later on today. Well, young lady, have you decided to help me out with the talent for the show?
Yes, but Mr. Grover promised me I could sing in the picture.
Oh, we got lots of singers around.
But when can I audition for you?
Well, we'll get around to that later, all right? Right now we got, we got Waylon Jennings ready.
Anita, come closer and close your pretty blue eyes. I guess it's too late now, but somehow you must realize what we thought was our world was only a dream world, and we just can't go on like this. Anita, you're dreaming of a world that can never exist. Anita, it's over, there's nothing that's left now to say. Anita, you're dreaming, and I know it's better this way. Anita, come closer, stop crying, and listen to me. I guess it's too late now, but somehow I must make you see. Each time you're with me, my conscience reminds me of someone who's waiting alone. Anita, you're dreaming, and when you wake, I'll be gone. Anita, it's over, there's nothing that's left now to say. Anita, you're dreaming, and I know it's better this way.
Hiya, Colonel. How's things going today?
Oh, hi, Marty. Pretty bad. I'm so frustrated, I feel like a duck that can't get her down up.
Oh, got a few troubles, eh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Say, let me introduce you to a pretty fair country yodeler here. Don Winters, meet Colonel Beedlebaum here.
A yodeler, huh? Yodeler? Oh, say, I'd like to hear him.
Maybe you could use him in your show.
I think that would be great. Can
I? Just sit down over and listen to him. Don, do him a little yodeling, will you?
Well, I've been herding cattle for about a month or more, but now I'm riding hard to get back to my baby's store. I'm gonna shave and take a bath and then comb down my hair, and I'll put on sweet smelling stuff that will fill the air. Oh, thank you.
That's very good. I'll keep in touch with you.
Does a good job, doesn't he?
Yeah. Oh, hello, Connie. Who have we got now?
Bobby Sykes is ready.
Bobby Sykes.
You treat me like the ground you walk around on. You say our love's not like it was before. And even though you hurt me when it's over, you know that I'll come running back for more. So I hope you learn the love from all your heartache. And they're bound to come to you, just wait and see. Yes, I hope you learn the lot from all your heartache. And when you do, I hope that you come running back to me. Sometimes I think you really like to hurt me. You're only happy when you make me blue. But every time you do, I keep remembering. Someday someone will do the same to you. So I hope you learned a lot from
You're lining up some pretty fair talent, Colonel.
Everything is just going great. But Marty, you can do me a big favor.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. You know what I'd like to get? I'd like to get some of the people like Farron Young and Kitty Wells and Johnny Wright and Webb Pierce, Porter Wagoner, and Norma Jean and...
I don't know if I can swing a deal like that, Colonel. That's a little bit out of my line.
But you know them all, don't you?
Hey, mister. I hear you're making a country music picture here.
Yeah, we are. Goodbye. Now, who else could we get? Well, we got Connie. Of course, you know her.
Hey, mister. Me and my buddy would like to sing on your show.
I've seen Broken Arms dressed better than that. Now, so you could help me, really. The people you know and have...
Hey, mister. Didn't you heard my friend say we want to sing on your show?
There's nothing I like better than have you sing on my show. Go right ahead, boys. Fine.
Gonna get our big break at last, it seems. They're gonna put us on the golden screen. We wrote everyone, even our mother. They're gonna show us in Technicolor. We know all men will surely grow weak when they see our magnificent physique. All the girls are gonna jump right up and scream when we come out upon the golden screen.
Oh, eat your heart out, Elvis Presley.
We're gonna hit the screen just like a storm. They're the biggest thing in movies since popcorn. They're the lot of the theater just to see us. We're gonna win an Oscar or bust. We will be a pair of matinee idols. Run around with all the stars and models. Other leading men won't know just what hit them. Our manic leads are surely gonna get them. So Hollywood, look out, here we come. Just like the Beatles, we'll be number one. Only one thing will stop us now, you know. We'll get left on the cutting room floor. Only one thing will stop us now, you know. We'll get left on the cutting room floor.
Hey, Colonel, when am I going to get to sing?
Oh, not now. I have something special in mind for you.
But you haven't heard me yet.
Oh, you'll sing all right. Don't worry, you'll sing.
But when?
Not now. Later. Later.
Quiet on the set, please. Stand by. Videotape rolling. Kitty Wells Show. Program 33.
Is love worth all the heartache? Is love worth all the headache? It only causes pain and misery. Is love worth all the heartache? Is love worth all the headache? It's worth it all when you're loving me.
Sometimes I say that I can't take no more. I'm leaving you, I'm heading for the door. But you never holler, stop, or please don't go. You know I'm weak and that I need you so.
Is love worth all the heartache? Is love worth all the headache? It only causes pain and misery. Is love worth all the heartache? Is love worth all the headache?
There's only you. You know that too, so who am I trying to fool? And you also know that you love me too. Let's put our hearts together, me and you.
Is love worth all the heartache? Is love worth all the headache? It only causes pain and misery. Is love worth all the heartache? Is love worth all the headache?
Here's the boy been with us about 7 years now, and he puts out one good record right after another. This one today is a big hit all over the country. Bill Phillips singing for you, Put It Off Until Tomorrow. Here's a young young lady that has won award right after another. I guess her den and all of the recreation room at home is just full of awards that she's won. For being the queen of country music, she's going to sing for you one of the award songs, A Woman Half My Age, Miss Kitty Wells.
Say I've lost you to a woman half my age. A lovely young acquaintance that you made. You say your love for me you laid aside. And she's begin the flame you thought had died.
I just got the Kitty Wells and Johnny Wright show all signed up.
Good, but let's stick around just a little while. Farron Young's almost finished taping his show. Maybe we can talk to him.
Oh, fine. Farron Young.
When day ends and night falls, my heart calls, go dream a dream of love. There's no dreams like my dreams, and darling, it's you I'm dreaming of. If my dreams are daydreams, and daydreams I have plenty of, there's no dreams like my dreams, and darling, my dreams are of you. Why did you prove untrue when you know it's only you? When day breaks, my heart aches, my lips crave the kisses we once knew. There's no dreams like my dreams, and darling, my dreams are of you.
Yay! Why not?
sirree. Welcome to the Fair and Young Show, folks. And right now, I think if we can hurry right along, we got time to do another song called I Miss You Already.
I miss you already, and you're not even gone. The time has come, you're telling me goodbye. And I know I can't keep you if I try. I've had too many chances, now I'll have to set you free. I watch you go, too late I know how much you mean to me. I miss you already, I don't know how I go on. I miss you already, and you're not even gone. So kiss me once again, and please don't cry. I promise there'll be no more alibi. I'll have to find myself a way to face this loneliness. I was untrue, mistreated you. I lost my happiness. I miss you already, I don't know how I go on. I miss you already, and you're not even gone.
Hey, Colonel Beedlebaum, you're wanting the phone back here.
Who is it?
I think it's Hollywood.
Hello?
Beedlebaum, this is J.B. What's going on out there?
Oh, everything's going just fine, boss. I've seen a lot of great acts.
Well, have you signed any of the groups yet?
No, we can't seem to agree.
Well, have you contacted people like Webb Pierce, Bill Anderson, and...
Well, you know what? I'm going to get to them this afternoon.
Beedlebaum, get those contracts signed, you hear?
Sure, don't you worry, boss. Don't you worry.
Okay, then we'll take care of these tomorrow, all right?
Connie!
Hi, Lefty. Colonel Beedlebaum, this is Lefty Frizzell.
Oh, Lefty? Why do they call you Lefty?
Because I picked this left-handed guitar right-handed.
That's right.
Say, I understand y'all shooting a movie around here.
Yeah, we are. And we want you to do a guitar number. Mm. Now, you remember that one you do called Home on the Range? You remember it goes like this. I remember it because I remember it very, real well. Very well. Oh, give me a gome. I'm just a gnome. No, throw me a bone. Oh, no, I better start again. My voice is all right. Beautiful. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, and I'll show you a dirty home. Once more. Oh, give me a home with a ruffalo bone, a buffalo buff, a buffalo bill, a B.I.B.O., a Batman. Do you know why the girl wouldn't kiss Batman? Because he had bad breath. Daniel Boone. I know Danny Boone's daughter, Bab. Bab Boone's!
Let me do it by myself. Oh. Let me do it my own way.
I guess so. I'm a failure.
Oh.
love you, I'll prove it to you someday. I love you, and my heart you'll always stay. I've been so blue and lonesome all these days. I love you, I'll prove it a thousand ways. I'll be nice and sweet to you, and no more will you be blue. I'll prove I love you every day, all kinds of ways. So darling, please wait. Please wait until I'm free. There'll be a change, a great change made in me. I'll be true, there'll never be blue days. I love you, I'll prove a thousand ways.
This will be the Connie Smith rehearsal. Keep rolling.
Connie, you really can sing.
Thank you, Colonel.
We'll find a spot for you.
Oh, good.
I know, boss, but right now I'm at a rehearsal listening to some of the best acts I've ever seen.
Beedlebaum, you're not out there to entertain yourself by going to rehearsals. I sent you out there to sign up those people. Thank you, Joanne. No, I'm not talking to you.
Oh, what's the matter with you? Is your name Joanne?
What are you trying to do out there? Have yourself a ball?
Now, you listen to me, Boozlebrain. Here in Hollywood working like dogs trying to get this picture coordinated while you sit there in Nashville on your Perkins striker, not doing the job that
Beedlebaum, and listen to me good. You get off that dime, because in 3 days the camera crew are going to be there, and I'm going to be right with them, Beedlebaum.
Don't you worry about a thing, boss. I'll have everything all lined up by the time you get here.
Hey, Colonel, Margie Singleton is ready.
Oh, I gotta go now, boss. Margie Singleton is ready. Goodbye.
I saw you for the first time in a long time today. And just for a moment, the years were erased, and you had never left me. You'd been here all along. Yes, it seemed for just a moment that you'd never been gone. It's funny how the heart can move a mind and make you forget and lose all track of time. Still, the hands of time have a way of moving on. Yet it seemed for just a moment that you'd never been gone. You'll have to forgive me. It's just the fool in me still clinging to hopes and long-vanished dreams. But to love you seems so right. You were mine for so long, and it seemed for just a moment that you'd never been gone.
Say, sir, you're Bill Anderson, aren't you? The star of records and personal appearances and TV?
I guess so, yes.
Oh, how are you? Do you mind if I hear you sing?
Well, the guys and I were just having a little informal jam session. Be glad to have you listen.
Great.
Thank you. Guys, let's strike up a little bit of Po' Folks here.
There's a whole lot of people looking down their noses at me, 'cause I didn't come from a wealthy family. There was 10 of us living in a two-room shack on the banks of the river by the railroad track. We kept chickens and a pen in the back, and everybody said we was poor folks. My daddy was a farmer, but all he ever raised was us. He dug a 40-foot well, hit 36 gallons of dust. The Salvation Army gave us clothes to wear. A man from the county came to cut our hair. We lived next door to a millionaire, but we wasn't nothing except poor folks. Poor folks are living in a rich folks' world. We sure was a hungry bunch. If the wolf had ever come to our front door, he'd have had to brought a picnic lunch. But we had something in our house money can't buy. Kept us warm in the winter, cool when the sun was high. For whenever we didn't have food enough, and the howling winds would get pretty rough, we patched the cracks and set the table with love. 'Cause that's what you do when you're poor folks, and we wasn't nothing except poor folks. Mama and daddy was poor folks, brother and sister was poor folks, my dog and my cat was poor folks, and even our drummer is poor folks.
Colonel, we've got another song. If you've got time to listen, this is one of our newer ones called I Love You Drops. Got time to hear it? Fine.
They're not teardrops, just sincere drops. They're I love you drops, 'cause I love you. They were on my pillow when I woke up this morning. They were on the letter I tried all day to write. And just a little while ago, I saw them falling on your picture as I kissed you goodnight. I love you, drops. I miss you, drops. Hurry home, drops. You've been gone so long, drops. They're not teardrops, just sincere drops. Say I'm lonesome and I love you. Never knew this heart could hurt the way it hurts for you. I never lived so many lifetimes in a week. Why don't you come back to me the way you said you would? And kiss these little crystals off my cheek. I love you, drops. I miss you, drops. Hurry home, drops. You've been gone so long, drops. They're not teardrops, just sincere drops. Say I'm lonesome and I love you. I love you.
Marty.
Colonel, old boy, how you doing today?
Fine.
Say, I want you to meet one of the prettiest things we've got in Nashville, Tennessee, Miss Dottie West.
Hi, Colonel. It's so nice to meet you.
How do you do? You going to sing for us, maybe?
I just happen to have a couple of songs with me.
Hey, come on. You're going to like this.
Would you hold it against me if I just see him one more time, just so I can make certain I can leave him behind? Would it make any difference if I just hold him once again? Now you know that I love you, but have I forgotten him? For he was my love till you came my way. So I can't help but wonder, have I made a mistake? Just suppose I remember the things he used to say after you hold it against me if I just see him once again. Then I'll know that I love you and that I've forgotten him.
Would you mind if I just sing one more song, Colonel? My baby back again.
my baby back again. He's sorry once again. Once more I'll understand. Here comes my baby back again. My arms are open wide to let more hurt inside. Here comes my baby back again. He's sorry once again. Once more I'll understand. Here comes my baby back again. Here comes my baby back again.
All right, Beedlebaum, report.
Who do you have signed up?
Well,
You got Marty Robbins under contract.
No, he can't make up his mind.
Can't make up his mind. What about the Stoneman family?
Oh, the Stoneman, the one with all the kids? Well, no, I don't have them yet. Well,
the Carter family?
No.
What about Porter Wagoner?
Well, yeah, no.
Well, then just whom do you have?
Well, I have,
Beedlebaum! You realize those cameras roll tomorrow? Well, Colonel, you get that show on the road or
you'll be reduced back to private so fast it'll make your head swim.
Let's have it quiet on the set. All right, this is going to be a take now. Bring up those background lights.
I left you this morning. couldn't take anymore. You left and you dared me to walk out the door. You said that I'd come back. You knew what I'd do. And you know you were right, 'cause I'm back here tonight, begging to you. I won't disappoint you, I'm begging to stay. That's what you wanted here anyway. It must make you happy to make me so blue. What a pitiful sight I must be tonight, begging. Don't want my loving, but you let me stay around, I guess just to walk on, so you won't touch the ground. To you it don't matter what you caused me to do, as long as you keep me begging to you.
Pleasure to present one of the real veterans of country music show business, the famous Pop Stoneman, whose recording history goes back to the year 1925. And Pop's brought along his family, and they do all sorts of things on the stage. I think you're going to really enjoy their show. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's make welcome the famous Stoneman family.
Never been a place so lonely as the people. glory ride. Oh, I took a creek to have a little fun. Throw my bitches up to my knees. Way down the creek when I please.
Country records, I know you must have a few by our next star, because so many people have bought his records for so many years. One of country music's all-time greats, and he's been everywhere. Here's the singing ranger, Hank Snow.
I was holding my pan along the dusty when a buckle, well, along came a scent line with a hind canvas cover. If you're going to with a buck of mine, he can ride. So I climbed into the cab and then I settled down inside. He asked me if I'd seen a road with so much dust and sand, and I said, listen, bud, I travel every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere, man, from the desert bear, man, I breathe the mountain air, man, I travel, I've had my share, man, I've been everywhere. Benarino, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Manawa, Lapaloma, Bangor, Baltimore, Alabama, Amarillo, Tocumbo, Laverne, Palamba, Delhi, McGill, I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere, man, from the desert bear, man, I breathe the mountain air. Chairman of travel, I've been my chairman, I've been everywhere. Boston, Charleston, Dayton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kingston, Texas, Canada, Monterey, Ferdinand, Santa Fe, Talbot, Glen Rock, Black Rock, Blue Rock, Osceola, Tennessee, and the Sea, Chippewa, Spirit Lake, Randall Lake, Devil Lake, Crater Lake, Beach Lake, I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere, man, from the desert bear, man, I breathe the mountain air, man, travel, I've been my chairman, I've been everywhere. Like a Jeff, Jack, the Waddle, Costa Rica, Fitzville, Spring, the Baker, Fitzree, Water, Hattensack, Cadillac, one leg, that one eye, the Holy Jolly, I've seen it, I've seen it, I've seen it, Catalina, the Seal, the Means, I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere, man, from the desert bear, man, I breathe the mountain air, man, I travel, I've been my share, man, I've been everywhere. Pittsburgh, Pipe, Grab, a Brick, Crawl, Red Owl, Spring, Rexburg, Mix, McGowan, a Rattle, there, one ass, one half a short, Jack, Chicken, Chass, and a Brass, and a last. Like a fair for Waterloo, Council, Kansas City, two cities, city, city, down, city, one, city, I've been everywhere, man, I've been everywhere, man, from the desert bear, man, I breathe the mountain air, man, I travel as it's my chair, man.
Well, oh, someplace you haven't been.
I've been everywhere.
Thank you very much, friends and neighbors, thank you. Now, before I do this next song, I would like to introduce the boys in the band, the Rainbow Ranch Boys. Namely, Jimmy Widener, our bass player.
Thank you.
Johnny Johnson, our rhythm guitar player.
Thank you.
Chubby Wise, our fiddle player. And last, but by no means least, Jimmy Crawford, our steel guitar player. Now, friends, here's an old song that I wrote and recorded many, many years ago. I kind of hope that you still remember it and that you still like it. Just a faded petal from a beautiful bouquet, boy. Thank you.
And now here's a combination that's mighty hard to beat. The banjo, the mandolin, and the best country music harmony you've ever heard. It's our pleasure to present the Osborne Brothers, Bob and Sonny, along with Dale Sled.
It's a mighty, mighty long road. One ain't got no end.
It's a mighty, mighty long road. What ain't got no end. know it's a long way from the butcher shop to records, television, and movies, but here's one of country music's brightest stars who made it. It's our pleasure to present the thin man from West Plains, Missouri, Porter Wagoner.
Thank you so very much. I'd like to do a song for you now that's a story about an old boy who made a few too many mistakes in life and wound up on a skid row. It's called Skid Row Joe.
Skid Row Joe. Last night, that's who I found in the dirty part of town. Lost, forgotten, with no place to go. Tormented with a bitter taste, outcast by the human race. A mask of torture was the face of Skid Row Joe.
He walked up to where I stood on the street, said, "Pardon me, mister. Now don't get me wrong. I don't want your money, though heaven knows I could use it. But you see, this is my home. You see the other bar down the street? That's my home, too. I noticed you staring at me a while ago. You recognized me, didn't you?" I said, "Yeah, Joe, I know who you are. You was one time a real famous singing star, one of my favorites." He said, "Well, I guess you heard they took my babies away from me." I said, "Yeah, Joe, I read about it in the papers." Then he turned his head away and I saw the tears fall into place. And he turned to me and he said, "You know, mister, this is the only place in the world that I'm not ashamed to show my face. And I'm gonna quit. Yes, sir, I'm gonna quit. I'm gonna shave and comb my hair and get me a clean white shirt. Then I'm gonna walk up to her door. When she answers, I'm gonna stand up real proud and tall. Then I'm gonna get on my knees. And I'll say, 'Sweetheart, if you'll take me back, I'll spend the rest of my life making it up to you for what I've done. I'm so ashamed of myself, and this I want you to know.' Then I'm going to take my two little babies, and I'm going to hold them so close to me, I ain't going to never let them go." I guess I should have told him then that she'd already remarried again. But after hearing what he'd said to me, well, there was no way I could add to his misery. So I said, "Good luck. My best to you."
Skid Row Joe.
A little beauty to the stage here and kind of pretty things up.
Thank you very much. What do you want me to do now?
Well, I didn't exactly have you in mind.
That's just the way it is. Everybody looking for beautiful women.
Yes?
You take the police force now. They've added women to the force.
Oh, have
they? I saw the prettiest police woman on the way down here. She was so pretty, I just wanted to take the law into my own hands.
Get out of here. Oh, Lord. Now, here is a lovely little lady to sing a real pretty song for you. Let's welcome Pretty Miss Norma Jean. Here she is.
Greatest traditions in country music show business. The famous Mother Maybelle Carter, along with Helen, June, and Anita. Ladies and gentlemen, the Carter family.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the kind of sign. Because you're mine, I want the mine.
There's no swallowing place, there's no stopping place in that song. And that song has been sung a mighty lot of times, the old famous I Walk the Line. And the first time that it was sung, some 63 times ago that it's been recorded, it was written and recorded by a very dear friend of ours who we sometimes stand way in the background and sing behind. And he happens to be at our house today, so maybe he might let us sing a little song with him. Hi, Johnny Cash.
Hi. Thank you, June. Don't get way in the background. I'm honored to have such a fine group having me on this song. One of our favorites from an album called Ring of Fire, which incidentally June wrote Ring of Fire. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
Oh.
there when they nailed him to the cross? Were you there when they nailed him to the cross?
A musical troupe, a pickin' singin' folk group. They sang the mountain ballads and the folk songs of our land. They were long on musical ability. Folks thought they would go far, but political incompatibility led to their downfall. 'Cause the one on the right was on the left, and the one in the middle was
on the right,
and the one on the left was
in the middle, and the guy in the rear
was a Methodist. This musical aggregation toured the entire nation, singing traditional ballads and the folk songs of our land. They performed with great virtuosity, and soon they were the rage, but political animosity prevailed upon the stage. 'Cause the one on the right was
on the left,
and the one in the middle was
on the right,
and the one on the left was
in the middle, and the guy in the rear
burned his driver's license. Well, the curtain had ascended, a hush fell on the crowd, as thousands there were gathered to hear the folk songs of our land. But they took their politics seriously, and that night at the concert hall, as the audience watched deliriously, they had a free-for-all. Well, the one on the right was
on the bottom,
and the one in the middle was
on the top,
and the one on the left got
a broken arm,
and the guy on his rear said, "Oh dear." A lesson. If you plan to start a folk group, don't go mixing politics with the folk songs of our land. You must work
harmony and diction. Play your banjo well, and if you have political convictions, keep them to yourself. Well, the one on the right works in a bank, and the one in the middle drives a truck. The one on the left's an all-night DJ, and the guy in the rear got drafted.
Here's a young lady who asked to be country music's Cinderella girl because in the space of 6 short months, she became country music's most promising new girl singer. It's our pleasure to present Miss Connie Smith.
Nobody but a fool would love you after the way you done me. Broke every vow you made me, broke every rule.
Bird Brain, I didn't think you could do it. I'll have to admit you are a genius. Special thanks to you, Connie Smith. Just great, Marty.
Thank you very much, sir.
We'll do it again, huh?
Sure. Marty, we're ready for a take.
Okay, Will. Let's have a look, Connie.
Okay, fellas, let's hold it nice and quiet now for Marty's final number. Okay, roll, camera, and sound.
Rolling.
Slate it.
Scene 90, take one.
Okay, action.
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Nighttime would find me in Rose's Cantina. Music would play and Felina would whirl. Blacker than night were the eyes of Felina, wicked and evil while casting a spell. My love was deep for this Mexican maiden. I was in love, but in vain I could tell. One night a wild young cowboy came in, wild as the West Texas wind. Dashing and daring, a drink he was sharing with wicked Felina, the girl that I love. So in anger, I challenged his right for the love of this maiden. Down with his hand for the gun that he wore. My challenge was answered in less than a heartbeat. A handsome young stranger lay dead on the floor. Just for a moment I stood there in silence, shot for the foul evil deed I had done.
thoughts race through my mind as I stood in. I had but one chance, and that was to run. Out through the back door of roses I ran, out where the horses were tied. I caught a good one, it looked like it could run. Up on its back and away I did ride, just as fast as I could, from the West Texas town of El Paso out to the Badlands of New Mexico. Back in El Paso my life would be worthless. Everything's gone in life, nothing is left. It's been so long since I've seen a young maiden. My love is stronger than my fear of death. I saddled up and away I did go, riding alone in the dark. Maybe tomorrow a bullet will find me. Tonight nothing's worse than this pain in my heart. And at last here I am on the hill overlooking El Paso. I can see Rose's cantina below. My love is strong and it pushes me onward. Down off the hill to Polina I go. Off to my right I see five mountain cowboys. Off to my left, right, a dozen of more. Shouting and shooting, I can't let them catch me. I have to make it to Rose's Bengal. Something is dreadfully wrong for a few. A deep burning pain in my soul. Though I am trying to stay in the saddle, I'm getting weary, unable to ride. But my love for Polina is strong. If I rise where I fall, though I am weary, I can't stop to rest. I see the white puff of smoke from the rifle. I feel the bullet go deep in my chest. From out of nowhere, Polina has found me, kissing my cheek as she kneels by my side. Cradle my two loving arms and I'll die for one little kiss and Polina. Ooh.